With me, who's someone who knows Ray Tensing, he is Kevin Combs. He coached Tensing in baseball when he was a teenager. And by the way, he's not acting as a representative from the Tensing family whatsoever. This is just his personal perspective. But just wanted to take the opportunity to stand up for this man who he calls a very good cop and a very honest man. So I know, Kevin, I have you on the phone. Thank you so much for calling in. I mean, listen, you paint, from what I understand, a very different picture of the man that the public has come to know. Tell me about Ray Tensing, a man who always wanted to be an officer.
Yeah, thanks for having me on. He's always been a terrific, terrific young man. From a very early age, his early teens, he wanted to be a police officer. He did all the right things to go on that path and stay on that path and achieve his goal. And the reason I stepped forward to speak up for him is because no one else was, and there was a narrative out there that made him sound like he was this horrible monster, terrible police officer, which could not be further from the truth. And I want to tell you now, we all know that what happened was a terrible, terrible tragedy, and everyone in our community's hearts are broken for the Bose family. It should not have happened. We all know that. But this is a guy who, I mean, if you look at his personnel records since he's been an officer, he doesn't have a folder full of complaints from people. He was very, very well trained. Our prosecutor made some statements the other day that made it sound like he was a one bullet Barney Fife, but he's actually.
Well, let me just jump in on that. Let me jump in, Kevin, because listen, you know, you mentioned a narrative. We definitely heard from the prosecutor in this case, said that, you know, Ray Tensing never should have been a police officer, called the act asinine, and also the sister of the victim here, the sister of Samuel DeBose, said this.
He executed my brother. He calculated immediately. When I heard the dispatch on Thursday say they publicized what the officer said, and he said, shots fired, shots fired. Well, no, I called 16 people at least. What does a cop, when they say shots fired, does that mean shots are coming in or going out? I believe it means they're coming in. So why would the officer have said shots fired when he's dealing with a man that's dead in front of him?
Kevin, is it possible that there is an entirely different side of this man you coach, this man you came to know?
Well, there's always that possibility, but I think what people do and what people say when they're under stress in a terrible situation like that, it's easy to step back from it and say, geez, that doesn't seem right. And again, I'm not a law enforcement officer, and I'm not going to try to defend or litigate what happened. That's what the courts are for. He has an attorney. He will have a trial, and I think we all hope that justice is fairly administered in this case. And I'm certainly not going to criticize anyone in the DeBose family for expressing their pain and their confusion over what happened. All I know is that I've known Ray a long time, and he's a good man. He is a good man who certainly would appear made a really, really bad mistake, but he is not the monster that he has been portrayed as.